وأقول في القرآن ما جاءت به آياته فهو الكريم المنزال وأقول قال الله جل جلاله والمصطفى الهادي ولا أتأول.
A questioner asked, my husband is an only son and his father passed away many years ago. May Allah have mercy on him. His mother lives with us and I find it difficult to live with her at times. I know I am entitled to my own place, but obviously we can't leave his mother alone, so she will be with us forever. My husband expects me to cook for her, etc. How can I handle this situation in the best way?
Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen wa salatu wa salam ala abdillahi wa rasulih nabiyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. I think in a case like this, where the husband's mother, because of her situation, she can't live anywhere else. I think that there are two things that are really, really important in this. I think the first thing is that you, as the daughter-in-law, really see this as your means to worship Allah, and a way that Allah has given you to achieve and to attain Jannah by His permission, that you really strive to work hard to please Allah by pleasing your husband, and you see this as a sadaqah that you give to him, that this is my sadaqah towards him, that I'm going to try to take care of his mom because she is, she's in the situation where she doesn't have anybody else to look after or to look after her. I think the second aspect, after saying that you try really hard and you make the best effort and you do so, really having ihtisab, hoping for the reward from Allah and believing that Allah will reward you for it. The second aspect is that it's really important to ask your husband to organize the house in such a way that you do have your own space. Now, there's no doubt that this is different for different people. It depends on the house in which you live. It depends on your husband's means. Is he able to get his mom a separate apartment or not? You know, is he able to separate a part of the house, like the upstairs and downstairs? Is he able to give her own space, her own room, her own kitchens? Everybody has different means. But as much as possible, you ask your husband to provide you with your own private space. So it doesn't have to be the case that you're always together with each other and there's the danger of clashes, or she could be difficult and then it might be hard for you to maintain your patience. But to have some degree of separation. And subhanAllah, even in places which are very small, even when some husbands don't have the means to do too much, there's still a lot of ways that you can maintain that privacy, even if it's just in your own bedroom, that you ask him to provide a chair next to the bed, perhaps a sofa or something like that, whereby you can have some time on your own and you can have some space. And I think that is something which is really, really worthwhile. So I would say two things. First of all, that you see this as an opportunity to earn reward from Allah. You try your very best. You try to help your husband out by helping his mom. But on the other side, you ask your husband to give you an appropriate amount of space to be able to just maintain the distance which allows the relationship to be good and stops that relationship from turning sour because you're too close together and there are too many clashes that happen. That's what I would suggest initially, just after having read through your question, and Allah Azza wa Jalla knows best.
If you have any questions you'd like to see answered as part of this series, then you can email us at questions@amau.org.